What does Jesus mean to you? Is he God? Is he the Son of God? Is he your Savior? Is he your salvation? So I want to go to the phones. Please stay on topic and make your comments brief. You're on Truth Talk. Go ahead, listener.
Yes, thank you for bringing this up. Try and be as brief as possible, but it's a very big topic. First of all, there's a lot of scholarly debate, and always will be, about the accuracy of the historical record regarding whether a person, as described in the New Testament, called Jesus, ever really existed. So that's something that all of your listeners should know, is that credible scholars who have been studying this, in some cases the scholarship is going back hundreds of years, there's huge debate on what's called hermeneutics and biblical interpretation, the reliability of the biblical record, whether it's been toyed with by, for example, the Roman Catholic Church, etc. So we can't for sure say, except on faith, who and what Jesus really was, even if he actually existed as a real person. Now, looking at the Bible purely as a literary persona, the Jesus that people should focus on and the one who is downplayed is the Jesus who is definitely anti-capitalist. He definitely did not believe in the money systems. In fact, the only act of temper that he's ever recorded in the Bible as doing was when he overthrew bankers and currency exchangers in the Jewish temple. He was always preaching against the rich, against greed, against consumerism, against materialism. He was always preaching social justice, non-judgmentalism, and another thing that's been downplayed is the mystical aspect of Jesus and his teaching. What I mean by that is he talked a lot more about inward personal growth and development, calming the mind, prayer, watching out for your sense desires, being careful of how you behave towards people, and this is constantly ignored. The real Jesus was a revolutionary. He was executed, if the Bible record is accurate, he was executed not just because the Jews wanted him executed, according to the Bible record, but because he was a political revolutionary who wanted to overthrow the existing capitalist system based on money, greed, and consumption of earth resources. So I would say that what Jesus means to me, whether he was a real figure, an archetypal figure, or a combination of those, is a man who defied the human tendencies towards greed, materialism, violence, capitalism, and vertical hierarchies, a man who was totally radical, and that if he came back, if that Jesus from the Bible came into America today, the very people who most loudly profess him, these right-wing, pro-war, so-called pro-life, pro-war, pro-death penalty, anti-gay, anti-abortion people, they would be the first to crucify him. Jesus was the ultimate pacifist. He is not, as he is represented in popular lore, especially in countries like America. He is totally misrepresented, and that is my opinion of Jesus. And thank you for bringing this topic up.
Well, why do you think, listener, that especially here in America and in the West, Christianity and Christians are selective about the Jesus they want to follow in the Bible?
Well, you're a very perceptive questioner. It's because of human nature wanting to find justification for its predisposition. People in the West are programmed into capitalism, they're programmed into materialism, they're programmed into greed, they're programmed into nationalism, they're programmed into constantly buying, 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 desiring, 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 and war and jingoism and all that. So when they find a God, they'll try and shape their God, their Savior, to support them. They're going to look at a Jesus who doesn't challenge them in any of their issues, who doesn't force them to change, who only provides them comfort. Oh, he's my Savior. Right, but do you act like him? No. Was Jesus a guy who would have gone to a war with Iraq? No. When they came for Jesus, apparently, he told Peter to put away his sword and told them to let the soldiers lead him away meekly. I mean, why do they choose a Jesus? Why do they ignore the real Jesus? Because the real Jesus was an anti-capitalist revolutionary. Most people in America don't want to deal with that, including liberals. Everybody wants to spend, 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 borrow, 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 get the economy going back. Jesus had nothing to do with the economy. He was homeless. He was penniless by choice. He had the clothes on his back by choice. He lived like a naturist or a survivalist. He was probably, if he existed at all, he was probably something called an Essene, E-S-S-E-N-E, which was a sect of Judaism that removed themselves from the cities, removed themselves from, you know, technology, and lived near rivers and in forests and totally agrarian, ecological-oriented societies. So I guess that the Jesus of the Bible goes against how most Americans want to live. Jesus certainly wouldn't be owning a Rolex and driving a BMW and questing for capitalist success. Most Americans cannot harmonize the real Jesus with their lifestyles, so they've chosen to, in their own minds, fictionalize Jesus to where he's basically irrelevant in their daily lives. That's how I look at it. And these fundamentalists who claim to follow Jesus all the time, they're the opposite of Jesus. In most cases, they resemble the people that Jesus constantly spoke against.
Right. Thank you very much for your
Thank
comments.
Thank you.
I thought the listener had some great insight, and now